In part two of our lesson on applications of right triangles, you're going to learn how to do bearing given as direction one, angle, direction two. There's four steps to doing bearing in this manner. So let's get right into the examples. We're going to make a sketch for each situation. In this first example, the bearing is south 23 degrees west. Step one tells us to make a starting point. Step two says from the starting point, draw a dotted line toward direction one. So in our case, direction one is south. So we're going to draw a dotted line to the south. Step three says from the dotted line, draw a curved arrow traveling towards direction 2. So let's first figure that out. Direction 2, in our case, is west. So we're going to be drawing a curved arrow traveling west to indicate the rotation of the angle. Now the angle, in our case, is 23 degrees. So from our dotted line, we have to draw a curved arrow traveling 23 degrees towards the west. And we label the picture with the 23 degrees. Step four says from the starting point, draw a ray that passes through the endpoint of your curved rotation arrow. So we'll get a ray going here from the starting point through the end point of our curved rotation arrow, and this ray is our bearing. The next example asks us to make a sketch where the bearing is north 80 degrees east. So how about you go ahead and try this one? Pause the video, work on it, and restart the video when you're ready to check. Working through the four steps, first, we make a starting point. Step two, from the starting point, we draw a dotted line towards direction one, which in this case is north. Step three says from the dotted line, draw a curved arrow traveling towards direction two, in our case, east, to indicate the rotation of the angle, which is 80 degrees. So from the dotted line, we have to go 80 degrees towards the east. And we draw in the ray. So there's our bearing of north, 80 degrees east. So from our starting point, we're looking in this direction. The next example, we have to make a sketch where the bearing from point T to point V is south 15 degrees east. So step one says to make your starting point. And now in this case, since the bearing is being measured from T, we know that we have to call this point T. Step two, make a dotted line towards the south. Step three, draw a curve rotation arrow from the dotted line going 15 degrees towards the east. And step four is to draw in the ray. Goes from your starting point through the end point of your curved arrow. And we know that from point T, we are looking at point V. And there's our bearing south 15 degrees towards the east. So from T, you're looking in this direction towards point V. In this next example, D is at a bearing of north 59 degrees west from C at a distance of 13 miles. So go ahead and try this one. Pause the video and then start up when you're ready to check. So step one, we make a starting point and we see that the bearing is being measured from point C, so we're going to have to call that C. Step two, make a dotted line towards the north. Step three, we're going to draw a curved rotation arrow from that dotted line going 59 degrees towards the west. And then step four is connect your starting point through the end point of your curved rotation arrow. We know from C we are looking towards letter D, and we know that distance is 13 miles. In this next example, we have a word problem that we're going to have to solve, and we start off needing to draw a diagram for points P, Q, and R, and we're given four different facts to use to help us make our diagram. The first is that the bearing from P to Q is north 62 degrees east. So we know we have to make a starting point for ourselves. This bearing starts out with a dotted line to the north, coming from letter P. We know we have to turn 62 degrees towards the east, and we're going to draw in the ray. Now we know that point Q is somewhere along this ray, but we don't know the distance, so we'll just put a note to ourselves that that's heading off to Q. Second, we're given that the bearing from P to R is south 64 degrees east. So we start at point P one more time, but this time we make a dotted line to the south, and we have to turn 64 degrees towards the east, and draw in the bearing ray. And again, we don't know where R lives along the ray, so we'll just put a note to ourselves that this is pointing to R. The third given says that the bearing from Q to R is south 26 degrees west. Now we don't know where Q lands along here, so one thing you can do is kind of go off on the side, make a point Q, and look at what the bearing would have to look like. South 26 degrees towards the west, and you know that that bearing would be looking this way. So then you can imagine that just pick this up and move it over onto our diagram here, and if we make point Q, I guess right here, then we see we go south and we turn 26 degrees towards the west and we put in the bearing. And we know that that is pointing to R. Now we know this ray has to be pointing to R, and this ray has to be pointing to R, which means this point would have to be point R. Now our job is to start finding some angles within the triangle here. We know that 62 degrees plus 64 degrees plus angle P in our triangle would have to add up to be this straight line of 180 degrees. So we know 62 plus 64 plus angle P has to equal 180 degrees. So that's 126 plus P is 180, which means P is going to work out to be 180 minus 126, which is 54 degrees. So now we can label that in here. 54 degrees is angle P. Now next, we want to use some facts about parallel lines. If we put them in here, we've got this line parallel to this line, and we can cut a transversal through there. And we know that when we have parallel lines, the alternate interior angles have to be equal to each other. So looking at our picture, we see that this angle is 62 degrees, and it's going to equal this angle, this full angle here, which would have to be 62 degrees. Well, if this whole entire angle is 62 degrees, we could subtract out 26 of that to find out what angle Q is. So we can do 62 degrees minus 26, and we find out that that is 36. So now we know this angle inside here is 36 degrees. Now we can use the triangle sum theorem, because one angle in the triangle is 54, another one is 36, and then whatever's left over is going to be angle R. So if we do the triangle sum theorem, we know that 54 plus 36 plus angle R is going to have to be 180 degrees. Now 54 plus 36 is equal to 90, so that helps us see very easily that angle R is going to be 90 degrees, and we can put in the right angle symbol here. Remember, your sketch is not going to always be perfect, and I didn't draw these lines so that they're perfectly perpendicular, but that's going to happen a lot. Your sketch is really kind of a work surface that you want to use. Sometimes it's helpful to redraw the triangle off on the side, where we just include the parts that we need, and we can make it even look a little bit better. So if we were to do that, we might want to say we have point P, point Q, and we can draw in point R, and one last side here. R is going to be the right angle. We know that P is 54 degrees and Q is 36 degrees. Now let's find some more parts of this triangle. We have one more piece of given statement here. A boat traveling at 40 miles an hour goes from P to R in 3.5 hours. So we know that distance is equal to rate times time. So we know that the rate of the boat is 40 miles per hour. We know the time is 3.5 hours. So that's 3.5 hours, which is 7/2 hours. I think it's easier to write it as an improper fraction. Then the multiplication is very easily done. 2 goes into 40 20 times. 20 times 7 is 140. Hours cancels with hours, and we're left with miles. And we know that that is going to be the distance from P to R. So that goes here in our picture. The question asks us to find the distance from P to Q. So we are being asked to find this distance, which if we were using our naming convention, it's opposite angle R, so that would be lowercase r. So we have to find R in this picture. Now because we have a right triangle, we know that we can use SOHCAHTOA. And we pick one of the angles to work with. Doesn't really matter which one. We can use, say, 36 degrees. Then the 140 is the opposite leg. R is the hypotenuse. So if we're using opposite and hypotenuse, we know that means we have to use the sine function. And we would say that sine of 36 degrees is equal to 140 divided by R. Now the R will cross multiply up. Sine 36 cross multiplies down, and we get that R is equal to 140 divided by the sine of 36 degrees. And now we're ready to do a calculation on our calculator. So we'll enter 140 divided by the sine of 36 degrees, close the parenthesis, hit enter. And in this problem, we were asked to round to the tenths place, so then that means R is going to be approximately 238.2 miles. Now this was a word problem, so we're going to need to state our answer in a sentence. So then we would say the distance from P to Q is 238.2 miles.